Hi friends, welcome to my tutorial. This is Lakshmi Deepak. Have a good time. Today's my topic is, that means now everyone is facing a problem on declaration of classes, right? How to declare each and everything. So let us see our topic today, declare classes. When you write a code in Java, you are writing a classes or interfaces. Within those classes, as you know, are variables and methods. How you declare your classes, like methods and variables, dynamically affect your choice behavior. For example, a public method can be accessed from the code running anywhere in your application, right? Where if you declare something as a public, we can access that public method anywhere in the code overall in your project. Like, for example, mark the method private, though, and it vanishes from everyone's radar. Like, if you make it as a private, it can be accessible in limitation parts. It can't be accessible everywhere in the project. Right? Except the class, that means where private members can be accessed. If you declare the memory is a public, you can access that memory anywhere in the class. With no exception, if you declare your memory is a private, it can be accessible only within the class which was declared. That means it is a multi-inheritance. Like if you declare something as a private member in a class A, which is a base class, where B is a derived class, where we can call the main method private member into a derived class, but not outside of the class. That means a private member can be accessible within the class or outside, that means within a derived classes, not outside of the derived classes and outside of the classes. For this objective, we will study the way in which you can declare and modify a class. You will find that we cover modifiers in an extreme level of details, and though we know we are already familiar within them currently. Excuse me guys. When you write a code and classes within the, that means from the level we are already familiar with them. We started from very beginning, the most Java programming thing, they know how all the modifiers works. But on closer study, often find you that they don't, at least not to a degree needed for the exam. That means substantial distinction and are everywhere. So you need to absolutely certain you are completely solid on everything in the sections objective before taking the process or before taking to the interview. Okay, we know the source file declaration route. What is the source file? Before we dig into the declaration, let's go a quick review on rules associated with the declaring classes. That means before going with the declaration, we will see the some rules, some techniques on the declaring classes, important statements and package statements in a source file. There can be only one public class per source code. Remember guys, in source file declaration rules, there can be only one public class per source code file. Comments can appear, that means comments can appear at the beginning or end of any line in the source code file. They are independent of any of the positioning rules discussed here. That means comments can be appear anywhere in the source code, but it is just independent of any positioning rules of discussed. If there is a public class in a file, the name of the file must match the name of the public class. Consider. What we remember of the first point, there can be only one public class per source code file. So we have one public class. If there is a public class file, we have to map that public class file to the public class of a programming. For example, a class is declared as a public, declared as like public class dog. Okay, here the class name is dog, which is the data type is public. Class name is dog and data type is public. We have one class like dog and must be matched to source code like dog file name. That means now I want to import my file, source file from a location, from a hard disk or from a server, like dog, where extension is Java. So here dog is a case instrument. We know that Java is a case instrument. Before calling the function, before calling the files into a public class, the name must be matches to the class name of a public. Okay. When coming to the fourth rule, if the class is a part of a package, that means we know that class is a part of package. A package statement must be the first step. The package statement must be the first line in the source code file. Before any import statements may be present. Okay. And next one, our fifth point, which is more important, if there are any import statement, they must go between the package statement. If there is an import statement, they must go between the package statements and the class declaration. If there isn't a package statement, other than the import statements must be the first line in the source code file. That means if there isn't a package statement, then the import statement must be the first line in the source code file. Okay. If you have import statements, it must be a first line. If there is no package statement, then the import statements will be the first line. So if there are no package or import statement, the class declaration must be the first line in the source code. Nothing but if there is import statement, the declaration part in between package statement and declaration. If there is no package statement, that means in order, import statement will be first. If there is no package statement, import statement, then declaration statement will be first, right? Next point. Import and package statements apply to all classes within the source code file. In other words, there is no way to declare multiple classes in file and have them in a different package or use different imports. A file can have more than one non-public class. That means what we declare in the first point, the source code file must contain only one public class. It is none other than the file can consist only one public class, but it can contain multiple of non-public classes. Our next one. Files with no public class can have a name that does not match any of the class. That means the file which is declared as no public classes does not match of any file in the class. That means in a class file. And my next one is, now we will see the class declaration and modifiers. We know the declaration and modifiers, right? And although nested classes are on the interview, we will save nested classes declaration. We will see, that means we will save nested classes in the next tutorial. Now my intention, this code compiles just fine where declaration and everything. That means my class is my code, which is a method class name. This is the code which runs, which compiles just fine. But you can also add modifiers before the class declaration. Modifiers falls into two groups. We know modifiers are access specified modifiers and non-access modifiers. What is the access modifiers? Public, protected and private. Access modifiers are public, protected and private. Where non-access modifiers are including strict FP, final and abstract. Modifiers are of two types, where access modifiers and non-access modifiers. Where other and access modifiers are classified into public, protected and private. Whereas non-access modifiers are again classified into strict FP, final and abstract. We will look over the ways we can use access modifiers and non-access modifiers. So if you have learned how to restrict or allow access to a class you created, access control in Java is a little tricky because there are four access controllers, level of access. There is nothing but a levels of access. But only three access modifiers, the fourth access is control level called default or package access. What we say in only three, public, protected and private three. What is the fourth? This is a control level which can default, called as default or public package access. Is what you get when you don't use any of the three class access modifiers. In other words, Every class, method, and instance variables you declare as an access controller. Whether you explicitly type one or not, a method and variable declaration is a class can be declared with only one public or a default access. The other two access control levels don't make any sense of a class, as you will see. That means we will look over that which is best considered to other modifiers. We know that Java is a package center and language the developer assume that is for good for organization name scoping. We will see why the developers are saying like this. Organization, they were right and should imagine the nightmare. Three different programmers in the same company but working on different parts of a project were a class named utilities. If those three utilities can have not been declared in any of the exploit packages and there are any in the class path, you don't have any way to tell the compiler or JVM. What is the mean by JVM? You know, guys know that Java Virtual Machine. Which of the three you are trying to reference recommends the developers use reference domain names append to the division and our project names. For example, if your domain name is something deepak.com and you are working on the client code for the 12 points and steps programs, then you have to go with a something like .com. The name of ildeepak.steps.client, that you easily change the name of your class, where you can see how to access a class, nothing but a class access. What does it mean to access a class? When you say code from one class, class A, has to access on class B, is nothing but a, the class A is a base, the class A is a base, that means A is a base class, where B is a derived class. The code which contains in the A class can be accessed by a B class. It means A can do not know one of the three things. Create an instance of class B, that means if you create, what is an instance? The creating of a memory, nothing but an object of a B class. Instance means object of a B class. Extend class B, in other words, become subclasses of B. Access certain methods or variables within the class B, depending on the access control of those methods and variables. In effect, access means a visibility. If class A can't see a class B, the access level of methods and variables within the class B won't matter. Class A won't have any way to access those methods and variables. Okay, we have another class like default class. A class with default class have no modifier preceding it in a declaration. Its access controller you get into don't type any modifier in the class declaration. Think default class is a package level access. Because a class with a default, that means we declare there are four access modifiers. And fourth one is default, where it is a package level access. Because the class with a class A and class B are in different packages, a class A has a default access and class B won't be able to create any instance of class A or even declare a variable or return type of class A. In fact, the class B has a pretext that class A doesn't even exist or in the compiler. Will compile, look over the following source file. Where, now look at the second file. That means, as you see, the superclass, that means B is in a different package from subclass, where consider subclass is a T. Where the important statements of top T file is trying to figure cross to import previous class. The previous file is compiled fine, but if you try to compile from T class file to a something like, can't access a class previous. That means why so? It is declared as a private, which cannot be accessed rather than the class. Okay. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and I will get back you remaining access modifiers like public, private, and non-access modifiers in the next section. Thank you for watching my tutorial. Have a good time and contact me at Lakshmi, that means www.facebook.com/ildeepak. Thank you. Have a good time.